Rev up your engine! It's time for the Scotty Gilbert Channel.
Okay, it's happened to all of us. You pull on your door handle, but the door won't open. But at least in this case, when you pull the inside handle, the door opens so we can get to it to see what's wrong.
So we'll just take the panel out. Now granted, they're all slightly different, but we start by removing all the little screws that we can find. You remove this screw, then go inside here and remove this screw, then the whole assembly just pops right out. Then unplug the electrical connection, move it out of the way. Pop up any of these plastic connectors you find. And don't forget to look under the vehicle, because you're going to find there's often screws there too. Then as crazy as it sounds, grab the bottom, pull it out, and it on pops. And with a little twisting, it comes off the top. Like this. And most cars have this plastic. It's just to keep water from getting in and ruining the door card. Just kind of peel it out of the way. And now we can see inside to see what the problem is. It's all on the arms that pull the latch inside here. Now in some cases we get lucky and these little plastic pieces break and the rods fall off or come out of position, but not in this case. When I look inside here, I can see the top pink piece and the bottom red piece. They're solid, it hasn't fallen out, so it's the latch that's bad. Now this may be an older car, it's a 98, but it's still not old enough. In the olden days, those rods had threads on them and you could adjust them to make them looser or tighter, but we can't do that. This thing needs a new latch. Now unfortunately the latch is an obsolete part according to Nissan, so they don't make it anymore, so we're gonna have to try to figure out how to rig something. I got a small bolt and I filed a U in it so I can fit it over the rod, so the rod now pushes further down. I'm gonna slide that bolt on the rod and push it in under the arm. As you can see now, the bolt is on top of the piece of plastic pushed on the rod, and that makes it look like the rod is longer, so it gives it more pull. And sure, it is rigging it, but hey, necessity is the mother of invention. Let's see if it lets the door open and close now. Well, here goes nothing. Success. Now, of course, that little bolt might slide off, so I'm getting some of this JB Weld Quick. I'm gonna mix up the epoxy, put some epoxy on it, and that'll keep it from falling out of place. You just mix the two tubes up on a piece of cardboard, in this case it's an old toilet roll. Then you smear the epoxy like this on top of the bolt and let it dry for about an hour and the bolt won't fall out. And sure, really, you should replace the latch, but hey, if you can't buy one, you might as well just fix it so it works. Then of course you put it all back together, snap the door panel on, they just slide into place. Then put all the pieces back in and screw them on. Snap the power switch on and put it back in place. And screw it so it doesn't come out. And screw all the other holders back in place on the bottom of the door card. So the next time your door closes but won't open again, why not try to fix it like I did? Because where there's a will, there's always a way. And remember, if you've got any car questions, just visit the Scotty Kilmer Channel. And I'll answer them as soon as I'm done feeding these wild kitties that live under the railroad bridge.